हेलो किड्स, शुभ मंगलम एट लिटिल स्कॉलर हाई स्कूल। आई एम संगीता सिंह, टेकिंग 9th स्टैंडर्ड, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश। एंड द टॉपिक टू बी डिस्कस टुडे इज यूनिट 1, स्टडी मटेरियल। सो इन द लेसन, इन द पार्ट 1, वी हैव डन द पैसेजेस फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट बुक, एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू वोकैबुलरी एंड द ग्रामर पार्ट। सो वी विल स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 13-17, दैट इज सेक्शन बी, वेयर यू हैव टू एडिट अ पैसेज। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय एडिटिंग अ पैसेज? Okay kids, now read the passage given below. So I'll read the passage which is given here. 5 sentences in the passage are numbered 13 to 17 at the beginning. Now each of these sentences has an error. Let me repeat, there are 5 sentences in each passage and the sentences are numbered from 13 to 17 at the beginning of sentence. And each of these sentences has an error. Error means there is a mistake in each sentence. You have to correct and rewrite them in the answer booklet. Now, first passage, sentence 13. I went back into the room and sit down on the chair. I went back into the room and sit down on the chair. Now look here, I went. The word went represents it's a verb and it is in simple past tense. So when you say I went back into the room and sit down on the chair, the word sit represents present tense. So it is wrong here. So when the first word is in past tense, the second word also should be, the second verb also should be in the past tense. So you have to write the sentence, I went back into the room and sat down on the chair. Now let's edit this sentence. Question number 13, you have to write, I went back into the room. I went back into the room. And in place of sit, you should write sat, present past tense of sit, sat down on the chair. So, I went back into the room and sat down on the chair. In place of sit, sit should be replaced with the word sat, the past tense of sit. So, since went is in past tense, sit changes to sat. Now, question number 14. I opened the box below the table and took out a book. I opened the box below the table. So the word below is incorrect word. So you are talking about the word below is used for temperature or height. The word, please remember once again, listen carefully. The word below should be used for temperatures or height. You can say above or below. But here you are talking about the position of a thing below the table. Isn't it? So we should use the word beneath here. So you should write question number 14. I opened the box. We are talking about the box, the position of the box. It should be in place of below, it should be beneath the table. Beneath the table and took out a book. Took out a book. Now question number 15. I opened it at the table on which stood the lamp and a large mirror. I opened it at the table on which stood the lamp and a large mirror. A small comb lay besides the mirror. So what is the mistake here? It says I opened it at the table on which stood the lamp and a large mirror. A small comb lay besides the mirror. So the word besides means in addition to. The word besides means in addition to. So according to this sentence, this is wrong. The beside should be replaced with beside. A small comb lay beside the mirror means just beside the mirror, on the side of the mirror. So here, a small comb lay, replace besides with beside the mirror. Now question number 16. One feel tempted to look into a mirror when it is near. So here the subject one, the word one is the subject here, one is singular. So when the subject is singular, the verb feel also should be singular. So feel should be replaced with feels. Feels is a singular verb. feel is a plural verb. So, feel should be replaced with feels. When the subject is singular, verb should be singular. When the subject is plural, the verb should be plural. This is called as subject verb concord. Matching with that, it is called concord. So, one feels. Feel should be replaced with feels. One feels tempted to look into a mirror. When it is near. Question number 17. So, once again, let me explain you the 16th one before going to 17th one. One feel tempted. The subject one here. The word one is the subject of this sentence. One feels. So, one, the word one is singular. It represents one person. So, the verb feel also should be singular. The subject is singular, the verb should be singular. So, both should, subject and the verb should match or agree with each other, which is called as subject-verb agreement, which is called as concord, C-O-N-C-O-R-D. So, here, one feels tempted. Now, question number 17, I took look. You cannot say I took look. So, here look means one look. So, you should say I took a look. I took a look. So here one word is missing. I took a look. Now second one, second passage. Let us see. Again question number. This was the first passage. Now second one. Again question number 13. His birthday was coming on and he thought this was a good time to tell his mother what he wanted. His birthday was coming on. So the word on here, it's a preposition and it is a wrong usage of it. It should be replaced with up. His birthday was coming up means his birthday was approaching. And he thought this was a good time to tell his mother. So the preposition on, it's an incorrect usage. It should be replaced with the preposition up. So write 13th one. His birthday was coming up. His birthday was coming up and he thought this was a good time to tell his mother. So you can continue the same thing. Now question number 14. Mom, I wanted a bike for my birthday. So, the word I wanted represents past tense. So, here he is telling his mother that he wants a bike for his birthday. So, you have to write, Mom, I want a bike for my birthday. So, the word wanted, the verb wanted should be replaced with want in present tense. So, write, Mom, I want a bike. Replace wanted with want. I want a bike for my birthday. Question number 15. Little Bobby was a bit of troublemaker. Little Bobby was a bit of troublemaker. So what is the mistake do you find here? Little Bobby was a bit of a troublemaker. Troublemaker represents one person. It is singular, so we should use a troublemaker. So write, little Bobby was a bit of a troublemaker. So you have to insert a before troublemaker. So a troublemaker means one troublemaker. Question number 16. Okay. Question number sentence 16. He had gotten into trouble in school and in home. So here the words school and home. These places are considered to be small places. So we should use the preposition at in place of in. So you should write the sentences. He had gotten into trouble at school and in home. Please remember, for the smaller places like school and home, they are considered to be very smaller places, so we should use the preposition at in place of the preposition in. So you write the answer. He had gotten into trouble at school. In should be replaced with at, and again in should be replaced with at school and at home. Now question number 17. Bobby's mother asked him he thought he deserved to get a bike for his birthday. So something is missing. Yes, Bobby's mother asked him if he thought he deserved to get a bike for his birthday. So here the word if is missing here. So you need to insert the word if here. Bobby's mother asked him. So here you have to insert the word if. He thought he deserved to get a bike for his birthday. Now third passage, again question number 13. It was hot summer night about 10 o'clock. So you are talking about one hot summer night. So the article a is missing here. So you should write it was a hot summer night. So we are talking about one single summer night. So we should use insert an article a. So write it was a hot summer night about 10 o'clock. Now question number 14. I had my meal in the restaurant and returned to my room. So again the place restaurant is a place which is considered to be small. So we have to use the preposition at in place of in. Just like what we have done for school and home in the previous passage. So you should write I had my meal. Replace in with at the restaurant and return to my room. Question number 15. I listened a noise from above as I opened the door. So the word listen means paying attention to some sounds. The word listen is used to pay attention to some sound, whereas the word heard is used to hear some sounds. Please understand, the word listen is used to pay attention to the some sounds, whereas the word heard is used to hear to the sounds which are coming to your ears. So here the word listen should be replaced with heard. I heard a noise from above as I opened the door. So I heard, replace listened with heard. I heard a noise from above as I opened the door. I heard a noise from above as I opened the door. Question number 16. The sound is a familiar one. 16th one, the sentence is the sound is a familiar one. So here we are talking about something which already happened. So the verb is in present tense. So it should be replaced with past tense. Whenever you are talking about something which has already happened, it should be written in past tense. The verb is which is in present tense should be replaced by the verb was, which should be in the past tense. So the answer is, the sound was a familiar one. The sound was a familiar one. Now, question number 17. One could say that rats and I share the room. So here you are talking about could. Could is in the past tense. So the verb, other verb share, should also should be in the past tense. So you have to replace share with shared. One could say that rats and I share the room. Share, the word share should be replaced with shared, past tense of share. Now, choose the right word. Question numbers 18 to 22. Now, you have to complete the passage choosing the right words from the box given below. Each blank is numbered. Write the correct words in your answer booklet. So, once again, let me repeat the question. You have to complete the passage choosing the right words from the box which are given below, and each blank is numbered. Write the correct words in your answer booklet. And each question carries half mark here. The words which are given in the box are claim, appreciated, admiring, certain, uncertain, reflection, shadow. So you all know this lesson, so I hope you will be able to fill the blanks here. It seemed as if God appreciated that. So write the first one. 18th one should be appreciated. The snake turned its head. It looked into the mirror and saw its reflection. 19th one is reflection. Question number 20. I do not dash that it was the first snake that had ever looked into a mirror. I do not claim that it was the first snake that had ever looked into a mirror. But it was dash that the snake was looking into the mirror. That it was certain. Certain is sure. It was certain that the snake was looking into the mirror. Was it dash its own beauty? Was it admiring its own beauty? Was it dash its own beauty? It should be, was it admiring, means was it liking its own beauty? No. This was the first passage. Now let us go to second passage. The words given in the box are deserve, birthday, reflect, think, behavior, trouble, reflection. Now Bobby's mother wanted Bobby to dash on his dash. Bobby's mother wanted Bobby to reflect. So the answer is reflect, that is think. Reflect on his behavior. That is think about his behavior. So the answer for 19th one is behavior. Over the last year and said, go to your room, Bobby, and dash about how you have behaved this year. And think about how you have behaved. Think about how you have behaved this year. Then write a letter to God and tell him why you dash a bike for your dash. Why you deserve. Now, 21st one should be deserve a bike for your birthday. So 22nd should be birthday. Now, third passage, the words given in the box are presence, tempted, beautiful, handsome, parting, admirer, appearance. Now, look at the passage. One feels dash to look into a mirror when it is near. So one feels how? Tempted. So 18th answer is tempted. One feels tempted to look into the mirror when one is near. I took a look. In those days, I was a great dash of beauty. I was a great admirer of beauty. You know that doctor was a great admirer of beauty, and I believed in making myself look dash. It is handsome. He believed in making himself look handsome. I was unmarried and was a doctor. I felt I had to make my dash felt, make my present felt. He thought that he should make his presence felt. I picked up the comb and ran it through my hair and adjusted the dash. So what is it called? Parting. That is, you make a parting, separate your hair and make a parting. So it is parting so that it looked straight and neat. Now the next bit is rewrite as directed. What do you mean by rewrite? You have to write again as directed, means as per the instructions which are given in the passage. Now question numbers 23 to 27, each question carries 2.5 marks. Some words in the given passage are underlined. Rewrite the underlined words in your answer booklet as directed, means as per the directions given. Now for the first one, now each passage has 5 underlined words. You need to rewrite them as per the given instructions. The first one, Bobby, no. That is the question number 23, even if it was true. So 23, the word no is underlined here. So what is that we have to do with this word? Look at the question, write the correct form of the underlined word. So it should be Bobby knew. Okay, is the past tense of no, it should be knew. So replace no with knew. Bobby knew. K-I-N-E-W, it is the past tense of no. Bobby knew, even if it was true. So 24th one is question number 24th, true is underlined. Now what is that you have to do with the 24th one? Write the word that is opposite in meaning of the underlined word. So opposite of true is false. So write false here. Now Bobby was very upset. Upset is underlined here and it is a question number 25. Now what you have to do is with 25 is replace the underlined word with a suitable one. So you can write Bobby was very sad. So upset can be replaced with sad. He went downstairs and told his mom that he wanted to go to church. Bobby's mother thought that her plan had worked as Bobby looked very sad. Just be home on time for dinner. So the word on is underlined here and it is at question number 26. So on time means it is before, exactly on time. So it should be replaced with in time. The word preposition on should be replaced with in time. In time is to be home before time. On time is to come home exactly at the particular time. So here the word on should be replaced with in here. Now question number 27. Now Bobby's mother told him. Now Bobby walked down the street to the church on the corner. So question number 27, walked is underlined here and there is no mistake here. So you have to write the same word, walked. According to the textbook, there is no mistake in the word walked which is underlined. So please write the same word, walked. Now second passage. Has a snake ever coiled itself around any part of your body? A full-blooded cobra. So the word full-blooded is underlined. It is question number 23. So what is that we have to do? Replace the underlined phrase with a suitable one or a synonym. So synonym is a word which has a similar meaning. So the meaning of full-blooded is strong. So 23rd one answer is strong. Replace full-blooded with its synonym which means strong. All of us fell silent. Silent is underlined here. It's a question number 24. Write the opposite, write the word that is opposite in meaning of the underlined word. So opposite of silent is noisy. Now next. The question came up from the homeopath The topic came up when we were discussing snakes. The word discussing is underlined here. It's a question number 25. There is no mistake here according to the textbook. So write the same word, discussing. Now, we listened attentively as the doctor continues with the tale. So here the word continues is given in the present tense. Actually, it should be in the past tense because the word we listened attentively. The sentence is in past tense. So the verb continues also should be in the past tense. So replace continues with continued. Now question number 27. It was a hot summer night at 10 o'clock. So at is a preposition which represents the exact time. But according to the textbook or according to your passage in the lesson, it should be about 10 o'clock. At should be replaced with about. About means it is not exactly 10 but somewhere near 10. So it should be about. Replace at with about here. So replace underlined with its correct form, he says. Replace underlined with a correct form. Now third passage. Bobby's mother wanted Bobby to reflect on his behavior. So here the word reflect is underlined here. It's the question number 23. Write the right form of the underlined word, he says. So it is, there is no mistake in it. So you have to write the same word, reflect. No, on his behavior. So what is that you have to do with the question number 24? Behavior is underlined. Write the word that is opposite in meaning of the underlined word. Question number, so here behavior is underlined, it is question number 24. So write the word that is opposite in meaning of the underlined word. So opposite of behavior is misbehavior. So 24th answer is misbehavior. Now 25th one, go to your room and think of how you have behaved this year. So here the question number 25 is think of. So it should be think about. So replace of with about. Think about. Okay. And how you have behaved this year. Then write a letter to the God. So think, sorry, one second. 25th one is, okay, and the question number 25, think is underlined here, but there is no mistake in it. So go to your room and think. Then question number 26, of is underlined. In place of, it should be about. Think about how you have behaved this year. Then write a letter to God and tell him why you deserve a bike for your birthday. So you should replace deserve with deserve. So replace deserves with deserve. Write the correct form of the underlined word, he says. So it should be deserve. Okay students, I hope all of you understood the vocabulary and the grammar part, that how to edit a passage and identify the errors in it. And you have also, I hope all of you understood, rewrite as directed, like how to write a sentence as per the instructions or how to replace a word as per the instructions which are given here. Now I want all of you to note down today's Sakshi classwork, explained study material unit 1 page number 23 and 24, homework complete study material page number 23 and 24. Okay students, now we have completed unit 1 in the textbook as well as the study material. Now I want you to update your classwork, especially write the new words in your classwork and complete the grammar in your textbooks as well as complete the study material till wherever we have done. So I hope all of you understood the unit 1 completely, and I want you to revise each lesson and read the lesson thoroughly.